A new company that plans to mine asteroids is now advertising for miners. They say that asteroids contain huge amounts of precious metals, and to get them out, well, they need asteroid miners.
So that got us thinking about the jobs of the future. It may not be like Back to the Future or Star Trek, but can we predict what tomorrow's labour market is going to look like? So to explore this question, we're joined by future trends analyst Mark McCrindle and careers expert Kate Southam. Hello to both.
Good morning.
Mark, first of you, space industry. Is it the final frontier?
Yeah, and it's being broken. You know, it seems like it's a far-off fantasy, but you've already got Virgin Galactic in that space. You've got Boeing in that space. You had the first space tourist in 2001 take off, paid $20 million. Since then, there have been more than 400 of these space tourists. Prices dropped to $200,000. And if you keep in mind the original flight industry, within 20 years of the Wright brothers' flights, we had commercial airline industries, manufacturers of aircraft, and transatlantic flights. So 20 years is a long time. A lot happens in that space, particularly now. It's a boom industry.
Kate, what can you tell us about the kind of jobs we're going to see more of in the next 10 years?
Okay, well, back here on Earth, and a little bit more immediately, transport and logistics is huge and exploding. Think of all that online shopping that needs to be delivered just by itself. Health is huge and also expanding. You know, about a third of our population is aged over 50, so that keeping older people healthy. Also, technology of all kinds. Yeah. You know, in the last 2 years, the world's data has doubled. So somebody called a big data analyst is in really hot supply right now.
Right.
To interpret all that for us.
Okay. Any other big growth industries on the horizon, Kate?
Well, according to some research, veterinary services is one of the hot areas, looking up to 2016.
So that's interesting, isn't it? The more advanced we're getting, the more we're sort of turning
But it's not just the high-tech doctor. It's, you know, the teeth cleaner and the behaviour person and the groomer, as well as the eye specialist and the chiropractor. So it's all those things.
Hang on, we're still talking about pets, right?
And we're still talking about pets.
Okay.
But also, I read about feeding, you know, feeding an expanding population. Is that right as well? I mean, they're going into crops and agriculture and all sorts of things.
All
like that
technology around food,
exactly, and vertical farmers. So, you know, food security matters. We've got a growing population farming up, taking use of those of the building space, not just out. Weather modification offices into the future, you know, that can deal with climate events through science. You've even got traditional industries, if you wind the clock forward, like teaching. They'll become classroom avatar managers. So they'll use the technology and teach in a whole new way. So even traditional jobs are changing.
Okay, so if I don't see my two little boys, if I don't see them going into asteroid mining, where should I be pushing them? Into veterinary sciences and...
Classroom avatar management.
Classroom avatar. I reckon that would sound pretty cool.
What? And some big data.
A data analyst. Yeah, if I look through fashion magazines, am I analysing data?
Someone's data, I'm sure. We'll speak to Whitney about that a bit later.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much.
Think about.
Cheers.